Hello everyone, welcome back to another YouTube video. Thank you so much for clicking on this video. So, any guesses where I'm off to today? Of course, I'm off to Animal Kingdom this morning. I can't wait, I'm so excited. I love my outfit. It's like
this cute little floaty play suit, animal print play suit, and then I've got the little animal ears with Simba on the top. So I'm loving my little outfit today. I also went for my black Mickey backpack today because I have a different bag for basically every park. Yeah, I'm so excited. This morning I've got a reservation at Tusker House where they're all in their safari gear, so I'll get to meet Mickey and his friends in their safari outfits, and I can't wait. It's an all-you-can-eat breakfast with animal theming. I think the bread's got like cheetah print on it and stuff, so I'll definitely be showing you when I get there. My reservation is at 8:05, so I need to get going. It's almost 7 a.m, so it's an early one this morning, but Animal Kingdom opens a bit earlier. It opens at 8, but closes earlier, so it closes at 8, so I'm excited for my first day in Animal Kingdom. I have a feeling this is going to be my favourite park, so let's go to Animal Kingdom.
Hello everyone, so I'm here. It literally took less than 10 minutes to get here. I literally had to wait 2 minutes for my Uber, so it's been very efficient. I'm here at Animal Kingdom. I'm just walking up to the rope drop entrance, ready for my dining first thing, and I'm already loving it. It's so tropical and amazing. Hey everyone, so I am inside Animal Kingdom. I have just checked in for my breakfast reservation. I'm so excited. It does like family style buffet dining. Oh, is that my text number? My table's ready. Let's go. Don't drop anything. No. Let's go. This is my little starter plate. Look at that bread. So apparently these have jalapeno in them, these little muffins. So cute.
Waffles, bacon, sausage, eggs, and roasted potatoes. These slices of creamy Durban chicken with some syrup.
Thank you.
Look at all this food. Oh my gosh.
Hi, Mickey.
Yes, please. Thank you so much. Love your safari outfit.
Guys, this food is so good, by the way. Got this like chicken and rice. So good. Haven't even started on the scrambled eggs and bacon and that. It's all you can eat, but I'm like really struggling already. Americans know how to feed you, look.
I'm making my way through this. Got little bits of egg, a little bit of chicken, jasmine rice.
Look at Simba on the waffle.
That's not true, is it?
You're number one.
Of course. You shot it in like you're in the face.
We
can see it.
Made me laugh.
Yes! Donut number one! Guys, I am sweating. I am struggling so much. Donald made me laugh so much. Donald made me laugh so much, he was having me giggling. He came right up to the camera, well, you would have seen. He was a jokester. He was like walking around like a gangster. He really cracked me up. This is the patheticness that I've managed to eat.
This is how much I've got there. I'm desperate to have at least one of these and at least one Mickey waffle. But gosh, I am full.
Okay, everyone, so the sweats have started already. So I have headed straight to Pandora, which I've been so excited to see, and it is literally breathtaking. It looks like you've been dropped into the film. It's absolutely incredible in person. I hope that it looks just as incredible on camera. I've hopped in the Navi River Journey queue, which is like the little boat ride through Pandora, because Flight of Passage, the queue on that at the moment is over 2 hours. It's like 2 hours, 20 minutes or something like that, which I know it's always really popular. I thought I'd kind of leave that until it's gone down, hopefully a bit. So I've jumped in this one, which is still a 60 minute queue. So we'll see how long I wait. Waiting to watch Finding Nemo the musical. I'm so excited. I walked straight here from seeing the little kite tail show. Before that, I just got off Expedition Everest, so it's been perfect timing. Starts in 2 minutes.
These travelers came a long way, and they deserve a good story. So we're going to do this the way we do everything, together. Now, it all started.
When Miles and Metabolite named Dory.
Oh no. When they found that mask!
No, when they escaped those sharks! That part's scary! Oh no!
Nope! It all started with a little clownfish named Nemo.
Nemo!
Dad! It's time for school!
Alright! We're excited. It's your first day of school, Nemo.
Okay. Hey, Dad. Wouldn't it be If I'm in demand, shark and I'm at school.
No.
Or an angel fish. Is true the day has wings.
I don't think so.
Can you believe there are so many things? In the big blue world that I've never seen before.
Are you ready? What you want to do is follow the EAC. That's the East Australian Current.
Just keep swimming.
It's in that direction.
Just keep swimming.
Swim
slowly and all.
To Sydney! Dude,
you've traveled far. Must be swimming under the lucky stars.
Yeah, but you're
exactly where. Grab some shell and surf EAC with me. Go with the flow. Go with the flow. Go with the flow. Don't be a harsh lover.
I just thought it was great. Quite terrifying, especially if there's little kids. I've just jumped in the queue for Flight of Passage and I'm already on the inside bit, which is really good, and I've been in the queue like less than 10 minutes. That's really good, because earlier the queue was going all the way around the outside of the entrance of the queue. So I walked through all the outside bit and got inside the like cave bit already. So that's really good. So hopefully I won't be waiting too long. This is what it looks like inside. Guys, that was the best thing I've ever experienced in my whole life. That was incredible. Honestly, I don't even know what to say. That was incredible, like amazing. Best thing I've ever experienced. Wow. It is 4:15. I got in the queue at 1:30. So you do the maths. But that's how long it took. We went through the rooms, and just before we were about to board the Banshee, the ride shut down, so we then had to go through the little virtual rooms again to then get to a new room with the ones that were working. So our experience took longer. We went in there at like 3:50, so that's when we technically got on the ride. So started queuing at 1:30, got on the ride at 3:50. I'm now off the ride at 4:15. But honestly, that is the best thing ever. If you come here, you have to ride it. I would wait in that queue for 2.5 hours again to do that. It was so good. And I've been in the aircon for ages, so I'm now ready for the heat to hit me as soon as I get outside.
Don't worry, you're all funny to moments here. The show can begin.
Maestro, if you please. Hakuna Matata. What a wonderful phrase.
Hakuna Matata. Ain't no passing craze.
Hey, Homo, what are you doing over there?
My little legs can't make it down off this float.
Hakuna Matata. Ah! Ah! What's going on here? What are you doing? Well, this stinks.
Sorry.
No, not you, Pumba. They're ruining my big number.
Oh,
it sees me through. It's enough for this restless void just to be with you.
So I have had an amazing day at Animal Kingdom. I've just gone on Expedition Everest again, single rider. I was on it within 5 minutes. And I think that's probably my favorite, actually, my favorite roller coaster so far. I think I prefer it to Space Mountain because it's got different elements to it. It goes backwards, and that second time I rode it, I was nearer the back. So I saw bits that I missed the first time because the first time I was on the front and I missed some of the bits, like I didn't see the projection of the Yeti ripping the track up, and when you go through a tunnel he reaches out and goes to grab you. I didn't see those bits before. I'm really glad I rode it again, but I'm heading out now. I think on my way out I might quickly do the It's Tough to Be a Bug show, if it's still on, but if not, then I am going to head home. Hello everyone, so I have had a crazy hour. I went on Expedition Everest for the last time. I got myself a nice warm brownie and ice cream, little snack. I also ate some grilled dumplings from one of the little shacks in Animal Kingdom. So I got some nice little food bits and I loved both of them. Sat and ate my dumplings in front of the Tree of Life and it was just a really peaceful moment. I loved it. And then I finished my day with going to see the It's Tough to Be a Bug show. I kind of did that just to tick it off the list, but I'm so glad I went because it was so fun. It was really immersive. It was like a 4D experience. They gave you little glasses and it was just really, really cool. They had little spiders that came down into the audience. They had air blown in your face. It had water flicked at you. And at the end, I literally jumped, which if you know me, I never jump. Because they made the seats like go up and it was like the bugs were crawling underneath you and it was really cool. So I had a great day at Animal Kingdom. I got everything done that I wanted to get done. So I'm rethinking what I'm going to do tomorrow now because the original plan was to go back to Animal Kingdom tomorrow. I might go for the morning or I don't know. I might not go tomorrow and maybe go to Disney Springs. I'm going to have a think about that in a bit. But I just had an eventful little trip. I booked my Uber. I actually used the Lyft service. I got in the car with my driver. Her name was Rachel and she was so lovely. We were chatting the whole way, talking about this, that and the other. She was really, really lovely and I felt really comfortable chatting to her and the conversation just flowed because, you know, sometimes it can be quite awkward. And then I realised she dropped me off and it was a different Delta hotel. It wasn't the one I'm at. And I was like, oh my gosh. So I just got out and pretended to walk into the lobby because I didn't want to be like, oh, this is the wrong one. It's obviously my bad, I'd put in the wrong one, but I didn't know there was more than one Delta hotel in this area. So anyway, I then had to book another Uber. So I basically spent double on getting home this evening from Animal Kingdom, but you live and you learn. And my second Uber driver was really lovely as well. And he was getting me to think really deeply. He was talking about why Americans see England is so powerful and why they all want to go there. Good to be about that. And then he was also talking about global warming and I don't know, we were just having a cool chat. He's really made me think about life. So yeah, that was my evening. That was another thing I wanted to tell you. As I was walking through the lobby of my hotel, there was a group of like young girls sat having like a drink. Not an alcoholic drink, they were having like a Starbucks. And as I walked past, one of them went to me, excuse me. And I was like, yeah. And she was like, you're stunning. And I looked like this. What an angel. Honestly, she made my day. And they're so young as well. Do you know what I love? I love that here, everyone will just start a conversation with you. And people are just really nice to talk to. Because I feel like in England, everyone has their heads down and they don't want to start a conversation or they don't want to talk to you. Or if you say something, they then shut down and like block you out. That's what I've loved here. I've been getting to know lots of people and they just will compliment my outfit and start a conversation. Say, where are you from? Like, they're just so lovely. I did buy some bits today. So I'm going to quickly show you before my camera dies because I've got one bar left of battery. So let me quickly show you. So I didn't properly show you this yesterday, but I got this Mickey popcorn bucket yesterday, 50th anniversary one, which is so cool. And at Animal Kingdom today, they had Simba ones. I think it was so cute. You know when Simba's lifted up by Rafiki at the beginning and he's like this? It was like that, so it's almost like he'd been lifted up around your neck. It was so cute. But anyway, I got this one yesterday at Magic Kingdom. They have them in all the parks and you basically buy this for a one-time fee. So you can get this filled up with popcorn for $2 when normally a popcorn is like $6. So I think that's really good. So you buy this once and then you can fill it up in any of the parks for just $2 as many times as you want. So I've used that quite a few times already. I'm still stuffed from breakfast this morning. Can you believe that? 8 a.m. I had breakfast. It's now 9 p.m. Yeah, I got him yesterday. I then picked up this. It's a cute little pouch, mini pouch with the Toy Story characters on. They didn't have any other styles, but I got this because I've been after something that I can put my air tag in, and this I can just clip directly onto my lanyard so that anyone at home knows where I am at all times if they're worried about me. I don't know why they would be because I'm just fine, but I got that, which is really cute. And also when I purchased that, I donated to the Disney Conservation Fund. So they gave me this little badge, which was really cute. I loved the safari as well. Oh my gosh, it was so good. And then, just before I left Animal Kingdom, I made my first proper purchase of the trip. And I got this. It's a big, well, I got it oversized, t-shirt that says Walt Disney World on it, and I just love it. It's basic, but cute, and yeah, I love it. The material is really soft. I love the colours. And it was only $24.99, which I think is a really good price. I know that's a lot for a t-shirt, but it is Disney. I'll wear this so much. I might even wear it on this trip at some point. But yeah, I got this. It's 9:10 now, so I'm going to get into my pyjamas and sort myself out, wind down for the evening, and I might even start editing the Magic Kingdom vlog, which you would have already seen when you're watching this. But I hope you're enjoying the vlogs. I don't know what I'm doing tomorrow, so stay tuned. It will probably be in this vlog what I get up to tomorrow. So I will see where tomorrow takes me, but then the day after that, I'll be going to Epcot. So lots more fun to be had. So stay tuned for that. If you haven't already, please make sure you hit the subscribe button down below and join my lovely YouTube family. Everyone is so lovely on here and so supportive. And I just love you guys. I hope you're enjoying the solo Disney content. Look at me being a solo Disney gal. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye. Good morning, everyone. So today is Friday. I have had a nice lie-in this morning. Well, I woke up still quite early, but I didn't get out of bed until 9 o'clock. So I've had a nice lie-in and a nice little chill because the last few days have been very full on, as you probably know. I've been doing over 12-hour days. So it was nice to just chill this morning. But today I've decided I'm going to go back to Animal Kingdom this morning. I'm going to get the later shuttle bus from my hotel at 10:25. So I'm going to head down there in a sec. But I wanted to show you my outfit because it is so cute today, if I do say so myself. So I have this cute little green play suit on with a little cutout and tie up. And it's got this lovely leaf pattern on it. And to go with it, I've got my little Pascal ears on because Animal Kingdom is all things animals. And Pascal is a little chameleon. So I thought it fitted perfectly. This is from Boohoo. It's a little bit big, but the size below was too small, so I'd rather size up and it be a bit more roomy than too tight. I am gonna head downstairs to get my shuttle now. I've got this bag today. Also bring in this bag, which has a change of clothes in, because I thought I might want to change into some cycling shorts and a t-shirt after I've got pictures and stuff in this, because it's not as practical. Although it's comfy, it's not as secure, let's say that. But anyway, let's go to Animal Kingdom, day two. I thought I'd come and do it again, and I'm right near the end, and it's taken like an hour and a half, well, almost an hour and a half at this point, but I'm so excited to ride it again. Look, I'm right at the front, and that's where you go into the first part of the ride. I'm about to go on it again, I'm so excited. So first thing is some red birds, red and blue birds just flew across, and they were beautiful, and I just wanted to show you that. Just wanted to show you that I just got this. It's pulled pork mac and cheese, so let's try it. It's about, what time is it? 2:20. I've just got a flight of passage. It was just as amazing the second time. It's just breathtaking. You honestly feel like you're actually flying banshee. And oh look, there's a little bird over here walking past. And it almost, like, when you go through the water, like water hits your face, like mist. And you can feel the banshee breathing. Oh, it's just amazing. Right, let's try. That is good, but I'm gonna get rid of the pickles because I don't like pickles. And I've got a cup of ice water in this cute little 50th cup. I'm having a great day. I'm gonna head over to Expedition Everest again. Because it's got a single rider queue, so that's never long. I'm probably wait maximum of like 10 minutes. And that's actually my favorite roller coaster that I've ridden so far. So this will be my third time riding it. And then I think I'd quite like to do Dinosaur one more time, because that was really good. And once I've done that, I think I will head off. I might also meet Mickey and Minnie at the outpost, which is opposite where I am now. I can't do two things at once. But basically that's the plan. I think I'm going to be finished up here by in the next hour or so. Oh, do you like my bag? You like ice cream, yummy.
you for a while. Just been chilling. I FaceTimed my mum and Tim because I haven't really done that since I've been here. And I was going to go to Disney Springs for the afternoon / evening. But I thought to myself, I've got so much time to go there. I'm going to go home and rest and relax and chill before another busy day at a new park tomorrow. I'm going to Epcot tomorrow. Since I've been here, I've been doing like 14-hour days, hitting it hard, being very full on, you know. So I've just ordered myself a pizza. Today at Animal Kingdom, I got some nice food. I got macaroni and cheese with pulled pork, and I got a Mickey ice cream bar, which I had to do. It was a must, but it was a 50th celebration one, so it was dipped in like blue chocolate and then covered in the gold 50th anniversary sprinkles kind of thing. The next vlog will be Epcot vlogs because I'm going to Epcot tomorrow and the next day, and it is the Food and Wine Festival on at the moment, which I've heard is the best one. So hopefully I'm going to be able to try lots of nice food. Hopefully I'm going to be able to get a boarding group for Guardians of the Galaxy ride, Cosmic Rewind. Fingers crossed for me tomorrow at 7 a.m. Hopefully I get a boarding group. There's only one of me, so I'm hoping. There's the Frozen ride, I think, at Epcot. Basically, I'm going to experience Epcot for the first time tomorrow and the next day. And then after that, I'm at Universal. So yeah, I hope you're excited for the vlogs. And then I'm going to Hollywood Studios after Universal. So lots of fun content. I hope you're enjoying it all so far. I will check in with you when I've got my pizza. So guys, I am so happy right now. This is my little setup. Look at this pizza. And I'm editing. I am just so happy right now. That's me signing off this vlog. I'm gonna enjoy my pizza and do some editing. Got a really red chin. I will see you in my next video, guys. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.